on me. Guys, this is a powerful verse. Seriously. I will boast all the more in my weaknesses so that the power of Christ can rest upon you. Now, do you know why the power of Christ will rest upon me?
Because Jesus Christ, because he came as human as well. So he knows what you're going through. He knows. You are not alone. In your greatest weaknesses, Jesus Christ knows. You know, it's in our greatest weaknesses that God shows his power, even more as compared to our strengths. You see, don't be afraid or ashamed to let me in on your feelings. I'm telling you that today. Don't be afraid or ashamed to let me in on your feelings, because I am human as well and I can relate to you. And just as I want to be heard, I want to listen to you too. You see, number two, how can we be accountable is by recognizing our own strengths. 1 John 3:16. Someone do it here, guys. Lay down our lives for our brethren. Christ set the example, and now we are to follow. Ask yourself, what ability has God given me that could be of use to the people around me? Don't just look at your strengths for your own interest. No. Look at them with regards to the weaknesses of other people. And then now I'm coming to the final point, which is by being responsible people. So that is how we can be accountable, by being responsible people. People are aware of our relationship with Christ. People are aware of our relationship with Christ. That brings forth a personal discipline and management. People are aware of problems around us. People who are willing to take the initiative to engage in what's going on around us. Without even having to be pushed. Now, those are responsible people. Those are peacemakers. Those are people who are laying down their lives for others. Let me tell you something. Personally, I used to have feelings of inadequacy, as if I didn't know much about the Word of God. And so I thought I should just keep quiet and let the people who speak. Maybe I should go to a Bible school or maybe read some theology before I could speak. Those were my feelings of inadequacy. But God told me that his Spirit teaches us as we grow more and more on his word, in prayer, as we relate as well with other believers.
Because if I don't own up to my weaknesses, then how will I get help?
hold on to your weaknesses alone. And that's why we are here, to be accountable to each other.
Let me tell you, sometimes people's perspective of you is not God's perspective of you. Even your own perspective of you may not be God's perspective of you. God's perspective of you is only known by surrendering to God. And you know His good, pleasing, and perfect will. So if there is anyone like me here today, I am telling you, do not feel inadequate. Do not feel inadequate. Do not be afraid of being criticized, because God has already approved you the day you accepted the Son, Jesus Christ, and His Spirit. Do not feel inadequate. Just hold on to the positive advice and let go of the negativity. But in more and more, the most important thing is that you know Jesus Christ died for your sins, and through Him you have been made partakers of His righteousness. The good news, my brothers and sisters, is sufficient for you to open up your mouth and go and reach out. Tell your brother, my brother, this is what you are going through. Jesus Christ is the answer. Thus, we need to hold on to our beliefs and keep in line with what we believe, so that it does not distract us from God's path. The goal is our spiritual formation. By the grace of God, which is Christian maturity, growth, and character, derived from God working in us and working out our faith with each other. And that is the conclusion of accountability.